Hi friends, today we will look at the answer for question number 18 that I have given you yesterday. And I hope most of you have written the answer, and those who did not write the answer can now pause at the question and they can brainstorm the points and then listen to my answer. So the question I gave yesterday was about IFC, Independent Fiscal Council. You can pause, go through the question, brainstorm and then listen to my answer. Okay. So, the question says that there are inadequacies in the existing fiscal policy regime which can be bridged by IFC. So, the statement has two things. One is there are inadequacies in the existing fiscal policy. So, you start the answer and explain what are those inadequacies. Then it is saying this, saying that those inadequacies can be bridged by setting up IFC. So you tell how it can be bridged, and then the question is asking about discuss the need of IFC in bringing transparency and accountability in the fiscal policy of India. So you tell how IFC brings transparency and accountability, write few points. And then in the conclusion, for this question I have given three types of conclusion which you can use in the answer. So this is the overall question. However, it's always better to first start with defining what IFC is and then writing inadequacies of the present system. So let us define IFC. What is an independent fiscal council? It is an independent financial institution. It's a national institution that would look into the macroeconomic policies of India and help in creating a stable and sustainable public financial practices in India, and it helps the government in making such sustainable public financial policy. Also, it will provide an objective and scientific analysis of the fiscal policy made by the government. So this is what IFC is. Now let us come to the statement given in the question. What are the inadequacies in the existing fiscal policy regime of India? So let us look at them. One of the inadequacies is that we are not sticking or adhering to the fiscal responsibility and budgetary management targets. Actually, FRBM Act of India has given certain targets of how we should reduce the fiscal deficit and revenue deficit every year. But government is unable to meet that. Even today, we still have high fiscal deficit and high revenue deficit. That is one of the inadequacy. Then, the fiscal consolidation rules are not uniform between center and state government. For example, state government has a restriction on the borrowing, on the amount of borrowing that they can do. For example, Article 293 of the Constitution of India restricts the borrowing of the state government. However, for central government, there is no such restriction. So central government is going for more loans. Thus, there is no uniformity that has to be addressed. Other thing is, government instead of budget is most relying on the extra budgetary resources. For example, these are also called as off budgetary resources. What do they mean? Actually, certain government entities like public sector units go for extra commercial borrowings or outside loans. Instead of taking money from the budget, they go for outside sources. All of them come under the government. Later on, government has to repay them. So those things are increasing in India. Then even the fiscal deficit that the government is, that is occurring to the government, it is not shown accurately. For example, the actual fiscal deficit is covered up, is dressed up through innovative methods like government says oil bonds. Previously we used to say oil bonds. Now through disinvestment policy, disinvestment of public sector units, even recently LIC disinvestment, through that we are somehow showing less fiscal deficit. Actually, our fiscal deficit is very high, but we are covering it up. So because of this, the credibility of India internationally will be reduced. So we have to consider that one also. Then the budget forecast is improper. Our forecasts are not correct. For example, in the budget forecast, we are showing as if we are getting very high revenues. We are forecasting that we would get high revenue and we can reduce the expenditure. We are forecasting, but in the real scenario, what is happening is the revenue is reducing, expenditure is increasing. That has to be controlled. Similarly, the tax officials are given huge targets because of high expectations of the tax revenue. However, to meet those targets, those tax officials are following improper methods, also called as tax terrorism, trying to extract more tax from the public, from the people. Of course, because they have targets, they're doing that. So that is also improper. Similarly, the GST Council and Finance Commission are not working in tandem. Each of them are not coordinating with the another. These are the various inadequacies in the existing financial policy. So they can be bridged. They can be bridged by the independent FISL Council. How? One thing is, IFC frequently reviews the FISL policy of the government, and based on that, they will provide an alternative policy. They'll provide a better policy, which will make the public finance more stable. Also, IFC is a committee of executive experts. They're experts. So they can provide proper budget projections. They can actually show how much revenue we can get next year and how much expenditure will be there next year. By using this one, government make a proper budget. A budget forecast will be better. Then also, IFC can ensure that government will follow the fiscal responsibility and budgetary management properly. Because IFC can help government to reduce the fiscal deficit in an objective and scientific basis. Similarly, it can help different government departments follow good, prudent fiscal management with good fiscal consolidation measures. In that way, it can bridge. Now, in the question, they also asked you to discuss how IFC brings in transparency and accountability in the public finance. How does it do that? Let's look at that. You can write few points on that. You don't need to explain much. Just mention the points and write one line about that. You can say IFC can provide a scientific, rational and objective report on the public finances to Parliament periodically. With that report, the legislators in the Parliament can have an unbiased debate. In that way, it will be transparent. Second thing is, even people, based on the IFC report on the public finance of India, people will have awareness. People will know the budgetary constraints. People will know the budgetary constraints that the government has. So they would not go for unnecessary demands. Even the several political parties, for electoral gains, to win the elections, they will go for populist measures, like, you know, giving away free fans, free laptops for everyone. And these kind of things actually increase the fiscal deficit of India. IFC can actually reduce such populist measures by putting pressure on the government. Similarly, right now, assessment is done only once in a year or once in 6 months. However, IFC can ensure that periodically, at all levels, central government, state government, local level, different departments, assessment can be done periodically by IFC. Because of that, even the accountability of different departments will increase. Even IFC can compel the lawmakers to make a proper policy. Otherwise, IFC can make it public to the people how, what kind of public policies, financial policies are followed by the government. Even good accounting practices of different departments can be ensured by IFC. Particularly during emergency, as IFC has got a very good macroeconomic view, as it is involved in designing the public policy in tandem with the lawmakers, during emergency, IFC can give proper plan, proper direction to the government. Now, how do you conclude these kind of questions? The conclusion can be in different ways. For example, one conclusion is, you can say, why does India really need it? You can say, in a globalized world, the market forces keeps on changing. It's very volatile. In such a scenario, you need a national institution, an expert institution, which will guide the government based on the internationally changing situations. Also, this is recommended. Actually, IFC is recommended by several bodies. 13th Financial Commission recommended it. 14th Finance Commission recommended it. Even the NK Singh Committee in 2017, actually NK Singh Committee is for the FRBM, to review the FRBM. It also recommended to have IFC for India. Even the International Monetary Fund recommends that every country shall have an IFC, which will direct the fiscal policy of the government. Even USA has that, UK has such a body. Such a body, having IFC kind of body, will increase the credibility of Indian fiscal policy internationally. This is how you can conclude. Another kind of conclusion is to relate to current affairs. You can say that in 2019-20, the Controller General of Accounts said that the fiscal deficit is 4.6%. It is almost 0.8% more than the revised estimates. So keeping this in mind, because of COVID-19 now, the fiscal deficit will be even increased. So in such a scenario, it is must that India should have a body like IFC. One kind of conclusion. Or you can slightly criticize it and then balance it. For example, you can say that IFC is an executive body. Now an executive body having control on the people's representatives is not good for democracy. It will actually reduce authority of the finance ministry. That is why IFC shall be constituted, but its power shall be neutralized. I mean, its power should be balanced with the legislature, so that executive and legislature both will have a balanced powers for a good democracy. Good democracy. In that way, we can conclude the answer. Now, question for tomorrow. General Studies paper 4. As I told you, I will be giving GS 1, 2, 3, 4 on continuous days. And once prelims is over, I would increase the number of questions per day. So this is about ethical dilemma in the public administration. Go through the question, write the answer shortly, and tomorrow you can listen to my answer and compare mine with yours. See you, friends. Bye.